We've chatted about it. You've read the headlines. Where's El Nino? Chris Farley, SNL, loved his El Nino bit. Sea surface temperatures. Remember from previous videos, we look for warmth in these areas to indicate El Nino. Warmer than average, red colors. Colder than average ocean, blue colors. We had blue there as we were earlier this year when we had La Nina. Quickly overtaken by warmth. Warmer sea surface conditions, warmer than average, so we have red within the boxes. Also interesting for North America's climate, what's happening here along the Pacific with some cold here and then this big old swath of some warmth. That has some local impacts. PDO, things like that you may hear in other weather videos. This one, let's just stick to El Nino. Where is it? How long is it going to take to kick in and drive the global climate? So let's get down to our boxes here. 1.2 region, 3 region, 4 region. If you look right in here, the blended area between 3 and 4, what's the forecast like there? That's kind of the classic region where we look for warmer than average sea surface conditions. Depending on the agency, the threshold of warmth is different per agency, but for the U.S. and most of us, if you're a half a degree warmer than average for 3 straight months, you have El Nino kicking in. Let's see where we are in that box. There's your 3.4 box. This would be the 4 one, 3 and then 1.2, but again, kind of the blended area of 3 and 4. Where are we? This is a timeline. So going back historically, we have our La Nina conditions throughout 2022. Quickly subsided early this year. March into April, we started to see some warmth in that 3.4 region, and since April, we've been warmer than average. What about that threshold of 0.5 right in there, that dashed line? We are at that point. But again, technically, we should be sitting at that point or warmer for 3 straight months before El Nino is declared. That's kind of one way to look at it. Other agencies you may read require 0.8 degrees or warmer to be declared El Nino. I can see the reasons for both. Let's just stick with that half a degree one. So anybody online that's already declared El Nino, well, we're warm enough, but we haven't reached the technical definition of El Nino just yet. And then there's something else that matters. It's the atmosphere. To really be an El Nino, shouldn't your weather pattern reflect that? I agree with that. That's why you may see some agencies, and I'm not calling them out, I'm pointing them out. Australia is a very prominent voice in the weather community, especially when it comes to El Nino or La Nina conditions. For El Nino, there really should be an atmospheric response. So if you see forecasts out of Australia versus the US, the difference does tie largely into, is the atmosphere behaving in an El Nino way? Americans are quicker to jump on the El Nino, whereas the Australians are kind of waiting for the atmosphere to catch up. And there are other examples, I won't go into them now, but let's just talk about that for a moment. So we just covered how the ocean is warming. That doesn't mean the atmosphere is responding. The atmosphere to this point, to this video, has responded in some ways to La Nina going away. Two ways you can measure that, SOI, Southern Oscillation Index, and MEI. Both look at the atmosphere. Is the atmosphere responding to these ocean changes? For the SOI, very much La Nina values through February, has since tapered off more neutral territory for March and April. And then in May, we're starting to lean toward El Nino. MEI values also very much La Nina until about February into March. And then we started April and currently started to see that trend go down. So the atmosphere is responding, it's just well behind the ocean changes, could lag by several months. We can expand on that for a moment. The atmosphere, the wind of the atmosphere, is it acting like El Nino or La Nina? And it is a driving forecast, or a driving element of a forecast, I should say, is you look at that wind just off the ocean surface, is the direction more conducive to creating La Nina? That would be an easterly wind coming off of South America, flowing to the west, drawing up colder ocean. And that's what we have on this chart right here. Okay, but we're seeing a change here, getting into these warmer colors. The trade winds here, the easterlies, they can become westerly, and that may happen, but it's really more of slowing those easterly trade winds down. And when you start to do that, and let's say they're much slower than average, or could be westerly, but slower than average. That's when you see these warmer colors. What is that doing? That is allowing the atmosphere to tell the ocean it's okay to warm up. It's allowing warmer water to build when those easterly trade winds weaken, or there may be moments of westerly wind. And again, we're talking just off the surface here. And we've seen that much, much more here over the last couple of months as that ocean has been warming up. So now we're slowly getting rid of that La Nina wind and bringing in the El Nino wind. It just takes time. The ocean's already hot down here. We're just trying to get the atmosphere's winds. And I don't have a graphic to show it. I don't want to steal from somebody. I asked for permission and haven't heard back. But I'm not going to show their graphic because I don't want to without their permission. But there's another product that you may see out there. And it's angular momentum. It's globally averaged. What that is, the Earth. Think of the solid Earth, the chunk, spins, right? And then we have the atmosphere as a fluid, which spins around the Earth as the Earth spins. So as you look at this momentum, there's a product out there that allows us to look at how the Earth is spinning relative to the atmosphere spinning. That particular product is saying the atmosphere is starting to spin faster than the surface of the Earth, and that happens when El Nino patterns take over. So back to the original question, when does El Nino arrive? It's a matter of your definition. To some who say all you have to do is get that ocean to 0.5 plus and you're good. Man, that may work for you. That doesn't really technically work in the community, but America's NOAA, 90% sure El Nino arrives by the winter there over the next 3 months, unless something really wonky happens in the ocean conditions. Australia, BOM, says 50% sure we'll have El Nino arriving by winter. 90%, 50%, what's going on? It's the difference in the definition that we covered here. One primarily wants to see the oceans do something consistently for 3 months. The other wants to see more of the atmosphere's reaction to that happening. I'm not saying one is right, one is wrong. I'm just saying that's the difference that may be reading in your headline boxes, your mail inboxes, anything like that. That's the reason for the difference. It's not that NOAA's right, BOM's wrong, or vice versa. It's a difference in how you look at it. This video gave you the information you need to know on where is El Nino. But what does that mean for your summer? Check out that last video and some of my previous ones, and we discuss what El Nino kicking in rapidly will mean.